Hello everyone, welcome back on our YouTube channel Vance Vlog. If you have already seen our previous videos, you know until now we have uploaded two videos related to topic number 8. In total there will be 4 videos, total questions are 122. Today we will solve questions 61 to 90, and then in the last video there will be 32 questions. If you are new on our channel, don't forget to subscribe our channel, like our videos. We have started a video series. I just want to remind you all that we have started a video series for the preparation of theory of German driving license. Until now we have covered 7 topics completely and topic number 8 is ongoing. So let's do the question number 1 for today, or 61 in total. What must you note when you overtaking the cyclist in this situation? Very important thing, whenever you are overtaking a cyclist, remember you have to maintain a minimum distance of 1.5 meter. If you are not able to maintain a distance of 1.5 meter, then you should stay for some time behind the cyclist. Until then the road is clear, then you can overtake. If you see in this situation, the road is taking the right turn, and if you want to overtake the cyclist over here, maybe you can maintain a distance of 1.5 meter, but you don't know other traffic can come from the opposite direction, or even while taking the right turn cyclists will come out. It's very natural, when somebody is taking the right turn, it will definitely will go out and then will take the turn. So we need to be very careful. Thus incline causes the cyclist to sway, because there is an incline and cyclists may be turned away from towards us. If we are overtaking the cyclist, maybe the cyclist will come while taking the turn, will come towards us. It could be really dangerous. So the incline causes the cyclist to sway. I must overtake with at least 1.0 meter of side clearance. No, just remember this thing, whenever you are overtaking a cyclist, a distance of 1.5 meter is a must, otherwise you are not allowed to overtake the cyclist. So only the first and third options are correct. The second option is not correct. Let's go to the next question. In what situation does a driver frequently underestimate their own speed? So like when you will underestimate your own speed, maybe the roads are very good and very clear, you are maybe driving at 100 km per hour, but you think, oh no, I am driving at 80 or 70 km per hour. At that time you could underestimate your own speed. There are many factors. Let's explore together. On wide well finished roads, like the road is wide well finished, maybe you are like you are accelerating your car, but you have no feeling because the road is very good. You think that maybe I have a speed of 120 km per hour or 100, but you are traveling on 150, let's say. So over there you can underestimate your own speed. After a long journey at high speed, like you have been driving a long time like at a very high speed, now you have lost the feeling for your speed. So maybe like because you are traveling at a very high speed since a very long time, so maybe you think, no, I am like you could underestimate your own speed. So after even a very long journey you can underestimate your speed. On narrow roads with uneven road surfaces, no. On narrow roads, when the road is uneven, you will continuously brake, or you will see your speedometer, like how fast I am going. If I drive fast, maybe I could damage my car because of the uneven patches in the road. At that time on narrow roads sorry, you will be very careful, so you will never underestimate your own speed. But on well finished road or after a long journey at very high speed, these are two possibilities where you could underestimate. Next question is, what does the distance to be maintained from vehicle ahead depend on? There are many conditions. If you want to maintain a distance for the vehicle ahead, there are many possibilities. Like, how is the visibility condition? If the visibility condition is very low, maybe you need to maintain a high distance so that in case of some problem, you have a good enough time to brake. So it is one of the factors. Similarly, speed. Your speed decide like what distance to be maintained. If you are traveling at very high speed, let's say 100 km per hour, we will see in upcoming questions, on a highway, then you should have a like maybe distance of like 2 seconds, let's say, or sometimes half of your speed. Like if you are traveling at 100 km per hour, then 50 meter. There are many factors. Similarly, state of the road surface. If road surface is like, maybe if road surface is uneven, if road surface is good, all of the factor tells you how much the distance can be maintained, or like what does the distance need to be maintained. All three factors are correct. All three factor actually influence your distance with the vehicle ahead. Let's move to the next question, which is a video question. So let's start the video. You are traveling on a road with 40 km per hour. You have priority here. If in your back mirror, back view mirror, you see a gray car is coming, and then it is directly entering our lane. If you see, I will again play the video. Just like if you see in the back mirror, there is a blue car, and you see this gray car which has overtaken the blue car, and now will enter into our lane. Why? Because maybe the oncoming traffic is there. That's why the gray car is trying to come back into the lane. So if you see here, like they say, the oncoming traffic is also coming. That's why gray car is willing to enter into the lane back. In the exam, you should watch the video at least for the 4 times. But like here, I have just clicked on the question. So what is the right course of action here? You see, the gray car has like it's a not good maneuver, not a good practice by the driver of gray car. Like but he was helpless because he or she has overtaken, but there is oncoming traffic, so there was no other way for the gray car other than entering the lane again. So but it is a very dangerous situation. You should brake immediately and maintain the large safety distance from the gray car. So I maintain my speed. No, if you maintain your speed like 40 km/h, there is a very less distance from the gray car ahead. Otherwise, as far as the next car is concerned, that's fine. But now the gray car is in the middle, so you should not maintain your speed. I increase my distance to the vehicle in front moving into my lane. You should immediately increase the distance and you should brake immediately. Otherwise, you're gonna hit, because previously you were driving keeping in view the next car, but now the gray car has entered. Now you need to maintain a good safe distance. Brake immediately. And maybe if you want, you can switch on the hazard warning light, so the blue light will come to know there is a problem. So maintaining your speed is not an option, because otherwise you could hit you can hit the blue car. So let's go to the next question. What makes driving in a stream of vehicle easier? Like there is a stream of vehicles ahead you, behind you, a lot of vehicles. So how could you help yourself? What makes driving easier? Keeping your hazard warning light switch on when driving? No. You only switch on your hazard warning light when there is a traffic jam in front of you. You want to inform the cars behind you that there is some traffic jam, or let's say for God's sake, like there could be some accident, let's say. So like there could be problem, then only you switch on the hazard warning light. In the normal stream, if there is no such condition, you don't need to switch on your hazard warning light. Watching the queue through the windows of the vehicle traveling in front, like it can make your driving easier. Like for example, you are keeping a view on all the vehicles ahead of you through the main screen, or through the window of your car. Like you are taking a view of all the cars, how they are behaving, how fast they are going. Even driving in slightly staggered position in your own lane, like you are a little staggered, let's say like you are a bit left or right from your steering and looking out like what is happening in front of me, it could sometime really help you. So that you can take your decision immediately, keeping in view there are a lot of vehicles ahead of you, and you can brake in time, you can accelerate in time. So you will not you will not create problem for the traffic flow. So there are many factors, but hazard warning light will only be turned on, we have already discussed this, and we will discuss it again and again, only and only when there's a traffic jam or some emergency condition, let's say. So let's go to the next question. When leaving a built-up area, both you and the vehicle approximately 15 meter ahead of you increase speed from 50 km/h to 100 km/h. Like you have like left the build-up area, let's say you have left the urban area where the speed was 50 km/h, and you were maintaining a distance of 15 meter, which is, we will see this question, but whenever you are inside the city, you should maintain a distance of 15 meter the car ahead of you. But now you are traveling at 100 km/h because you have left the build-up area. Now you are allowed till maximum 100 km/h. Whenever you are inside build-up area, you should maintain a distance of 15 meter with the car ahead. And when you are like leaving the build-up area, then when you are traveling at especially 100 km/h, I told you few minutes back, then your safety distance should be half of your speed. Like currently you are traveling at 100 km/h, so now your traveling distance should be at least 250 meter. Like maintaining the same distance over 25 meters is not an option. Whenever you have the traveling distance around, let's say 100 kilometer per hour, then you should maintain a distance of minimum 50 meter, at least 50 meter to the vehicle head, which is half of, like, if you're traveling at 120 kilometer per hour, then 60 meter you should maintain that distance. So there are many factors actually, but right now here you should maintain this distance as I told you. So 50 meter is the correct answer. So let's move to the next question. Our next question is a video question. Let's watch the video. We are traveling on a motorway for sure. If you see in your back mirror view, there is a car, and then there was a motorcyclist. Now he is disappeared, but now will appear. Yeah, if you see here, so the motorcyclist has come into our lane. As I told you, when you are outside build-up areas, you should at least maintain a distance of half of your speed. Like, let's say here is, if 130 meter, let's say, or better to say 120 kilometer per hour, sorry, if we take, then 60 meter you should maintain. Like, we will see again. Like right now, there is a blue. I will take it back anyhow. If you see here, if you see in the back view mirror, then there is a white car, and then there is a motorcyclist on the left lane, overtaking lane. Now this motorcyclist has now disappeared from our back mirror, and now if you see, he has just randomly entered into our lane. So right now, what should be our maneuver? As I told you, when you are driving outside the build-up area, so your speed should be, your safety distance should be half of your speedometer. So around, you need here around 60 meters. So what is the right course of action? I overtake the motorbike, it's not a very good option, because for that, you have to come into this overtaking lane, overtaking the motorcyclist. Maybe during this, you could hit the motorcyclist. It's not a good option. Move to the right-hand lane? No. Because if you see right-hand lane, there is a yellow truck very close to you, and it will be a very very immediate decision. Maybe the motorcyclist is also willing to go to the right lane. The best decision as a responsible driver should be restore the safety distance by braking. Like 60 meter, 50 meter distance you should maintain here. It is the right. Otherwise, like there is no need to change your lane to left or right. Just stay in your lane and brake to maintain the safety distance again. So our next question is, you are driving on a rural road. A line of approximately 15 meter slow moving vehicle is traveling in front of you. What should you do? Yani you are outside build-up areas, like rural road, and there are 50 slow moving vehicles ahead of you. What should you do? There is no way, because like I remain behind the line of vehicle for the moment. It is the very best decision. I overtake the line. If you see 15 vehicles, there is a long distance to overtake, like 15 vehicles ahead of you. If you want to overtake all of them, it will take a long distance to overtake actually, and maybe in the meantime the oncoming traffic could come, or it will take if there is no oncoming traffic for, let's say, still it's a very long distance to overtake. So it's not a right decision. Just be patient for some time, stay behind the vehicles. I flash my lights and sound my horn to urge vehicles ahead to overtake. It's not a good decision from a very safe or very intelligent driver. You should never, maybe in emergency situation, yes, but in normal condition, flashing your lights, sounding your horn is not a good option from a responsible driver. So be a responsible driver, and for time being, remain behind the traffic. What is the maximum speed a motor vehicle fitted with snow chain is allowed to travel? Like sometime you, in some areas, there is, you are only allowed to drive when you have your wheels like with a snow chain type vehicles are only allowed. Maybe if I can go to the ebook here, I could show it to you. I am not sure pretty much, but maybe I can show it to you over here. I will try to, but anyhow, it is a sign. Maybe if you have already seen our previous videos, so maybe in those videos, if you remember, like there is a tire with snow chain, and with that tire you are allowed only the speed of 50 kilometer per hour. So like you have to remember, we will try to make a bonus video related to the distances or speed you should maintain at different positions. But anyhow, for time being, with snow fitted chains, you are only allowed to travel with 50 kilometer per hour. You have to remember it, note it down somewhere, make a diary for that, and just remember it. You are driving at 80 km per hour behind a motor vehicle. So what is the minimum safe distance you must observe? So if you are driving at 80 km per hour, definitely you are outside build-up areas because it is greater than 50. If you are inside build-up areas, then you should maintain a distance of, let's say, 15 meters. But outside build-up areas, as I told you, you should maintain a distance of half of your speed. Or let's say it is also known as a distance of 2 seconds. I will try to show it here. If you see 21, 22, like this distance of 2 seconds, but anyhow, you have to learn it by heart. But I can tell you, as I told you, a technique. You have to keep a distance of half, like 80 divided by 2 is 40. So you have to maintain a distance of 40 meter from the vehicle ahead of you, or in other words, 2. It is divided by 2, like half. So you can remember by that term, it's 2 seconds. Note 1 second, 15 meter is inside build-up areas. So our distance must be of 2 seconds in this particular case. You can also see it here if you want. As I told you, like 2 second distance. So you have to anyhow remember it by heart, and this answer is correct. So let's move to the next question. Our next question is, you are driving in urban traffic on a dry roadway in a stream of traffic traveling at 50 km per hour. So urban, you are inside build-up area, 50 km per hour. What is the minimum safe distance you must keep? As I told you, it's 15 meter, or sometime like normally, normal car is of 5 meter length. Like it is almost everywhere. It's not 100% standard, but you can say a thumb rule. A standard of 15 meter, you can say, like any car is of, let's say, 5 meter. So in total, as I told you, you have to maintain a distance of, like you can see here if you want, how like some ebook is there to have more information. Like if you see here, abstand of the guy pick away lang and also circumference meter reduce yet word, then so 15 meter or 3 cars you are pick away. And when you are outside build-up areas where the geschlossene Ortschaft verlassen, when you are leaving urban areas at 100 km per hour if speed, then half of your speed should be a safer distance. But as you are here inside build-up areas, so 15 meter, or you can say 3 car length approximately is the right answer. What is the minimum distance that should normally be maintained from the vehicle in front outside build-up areas? As I told you, outside build-up areas, half or 1 divided by 2 speedometer reading in meters. Simple. Outside build-up area is half of your speed or 2 seconds. Inside build-up areas is 15 meter, or you can say a distance of 3 cars. You are driving your car and a caravan trailer, a length of combination of vehicle exceeding 7 meter. Like you have a car, and with the car you have attached a trailer as well. How you have attached a trailer? I will show it somewhere here. Maybe if you have... if you know this, I will try to show you how it looks like. But anyhow, I think I have to search a lot. But you know the trailer, which is normally attached with the car, and they are telling that combination is exceeding 7 meter outside build-up areas on a roadway with only one marked lane in each direction. What must you remember? As a rule, the distance from a car in front must be greater, must be great enough to allow an overtaking car to pull in. Like if your combination of vehicle, your car plus your caravan trailer is more than exceeding 7 meter, then the distance from the car in front of you and your car and trailer combination should be that much that if a car is willing to enter between you and the next car, then the driver should be allowed to enter into the lane. As a rule, the distance from the car in front must be great enough to allow an overtaking car to pull. Like let's say more than 5 meter, because if we know that a car is a length of 5 meter, then you should maintain a distance of more than 5 meter, minimum more than 5 meter, if you are traveling with a car plus trailer, so that if a car wants to pull in between you and the next car, the car should be allowed. The distance from the car in front must not be greater than length of combination of vehicle in order to make best use of traffic space. No, it should, like, it could be greater than even the length of your combination. It could be 10 meter, it could be 15 meter, depending on the road condition. But it can be greater. So it's not a right option that it must not be greater, like it should be exactly 7 meter. No, it could be greater. You may not drive like your outside build up areas, one mark plane in each direction. Actually, in that particular case, depending on the shield, it could be a traffic sign, it could be 70 kilometer per hour, or sometime maybe even 100 kilometer per hour. It depends, it varies. But you may not drive faster than 60 kilometer per hour. Outside build up areas is not a correct option. I think you already know this from our previous questions. Let's move to the next question. When must a car with trailer outside build-up areas on roads with only one lane for each direction keep a sufficient distance from the car in front so that overtaking vehicle may pull in? From the previous question we know, like if a car with trailer is exceeding 7 meter, exceeds 7 meter, then keep a sufficient distance from the car in front so that overtaking car may pull in. This we already know. Luckily from the last question it's 7 meter. Anyhow, you can note it down for your reference. To what must you pay particular attention when driving with winter tires? So when you are driving with winter tires, you should not exceed the permissible maximum speed. Not exceed 80 km per hour, no. That means that you cannot drive more than 80 km per hour on motorways with winter tires. It's not an option. With winter tires, you can travel even like till maybe 150 km per hour or even more than that. But you should not exceed the permissible maximum speed for these tires. Just look into the data sheet or maybe on the tires, what is the maximum permissible speed by the manufacturer. You should follow this. Only drive as fast when I am using snow chain. No, it's even lesser than 80. It's 50 km per hour. So with winter tire, you can drive as with the normal summer tires, but you should be familiar with the maximum permissible speed. So next question is, your car is equipped with the winter tires, so you have winter tires. What is the meaning of speed label maximum 190 km per hour on your dashboard? So if it is appearing on your dashboard 190 km per hour, then that means you should not exceed 190 km per hour. With this particular winter tires, you are allowed to maximum 190 km per hour. So 190 km per hour, the maximum speed applies to wintry road condition only. No, actually does not apply to the dry road condition. No, it may not be exceeded. It is the correct option only. Like the maximum speed of your tire is 190 km per hour. It applies to the wintry road condition. No, maybe in wintry road condition you will see the traffic sign for that. It is coming on your dashboard, not on the road. Does not apply to the dry road condition. No, like whenever the speed is mentioned on your dashboard, like depending on your tires, it is telling you it is the maximum speed which you can which you are allowed actually with these tires. Like it's not telling it is not telling you that this speed is applied to the wintry road or does not apply to the dry road. No, it's telling about you the maximum speed allowed with your currently with your tires which you have currently put in your car, maybe summer tire or winter tires. So what should you remember when putting winter tires on your car? So whenever you are putting winter tires on your car, what should you remember? You should observe the permissible maximum driving speed for these tires. As I have told you, you should be familiar how much speed my manufacturer allow to go with these tires. The tire inflation pressure should be checked in accordance with the manufacturer guidelines. That is also a correct answer. The air pressure should be 0.5 bar lower than the manufacturer guideline for summer tires. No, it's not a good practice. Even it is not mentioned anywhere. Just be sure how much is the pressure allowed by the manufacturer and how much is the maximum speed allowed by the tire manufacturer. The rest is useless. So let's go to the next question, which is a video question. So you are traveling outside build-up areas. Behind you there is a red car and white car is overtaking you. And then blue car is in front of you, and then if you see this white car is trying to come back, the white car is giving the right indicator. That means white, there is some oncoming traffic from the opposite road. That's why this white car is trying to merge into the lane again. Let's see this video again. If you see this white car was overtaking you, right now it has disappeared and now you will see it again, the white car. Now if you see, maybe there is an oncoming traffic, so this white car has indicated that the driver wants to pull in. So what should you do? As I told you few questions back with the bike rider, you need to brake and maintain your safe distance, because definitely this white car will enter after the blue car into our lane. Like you see here, this is the white car, everywhere white car, and now we have been overtaken. Now this white car again willing to pull in. So what should you do in this situation? In the exam, watch it at least for 4 times. So what should you do now? Now definitely white car will pull in. So what you have to do, just be very sure that your safer distance of here your speed is 60 km per hour, so it should be 30 meter. You should brake so that white car is allowed to come, otherwise you could hit the car. So I reduce my speed so that overtaking vehicle can pull in ahead of me. I accelerate so that the overtaking vehicle can pull in behind me. No, that's a very very harsh, that's not the correct answer. You could hit that car. I maintain my speed because there is a sufficient safer distance. No, there is no sufficient safer distance because this white car definitely will pull into the lane and will brake to maintain a safer distance with the blue car. Similarly, you have to brake and maintain a distance with the white car. So only first option is correct. Let's move to the next question. Where must you particularly reckon with dirt on the roadway and therefore danger of skidding? Like where you can predict there could be some dirt on the roadway. At intercity road, no. Normally at intercity crossroads, we have like, it is inside build-up areas. We have very good developed roads which are being like, there is no construction site over there. Very well developed road, intercity or junctions. You cannot expect any dirt or which could actually divert your focus or which could be a problem for your driving. Inside or inner city crossroad are good. Near construction sites, if there is a construction, then there could be some dirt on the road. Even at junction with farm tracks, like if there are some farm on the roadway, some cattle farm, so there could be like you can expect over there, there could be some like dirt on the roadway, but not on intercity roads for sure. So our next question is, what must the safe distance maintained be much greater on wet roadway than on a dry roadway? So if you're traveling on a wet roadway, you should have a more safe distance as compared to dry roadway. So why? Because wheel spray can impair my visibility. Like for example, if a car ahead of me, like if there is a water on the road, it's raining, that there could be a wheel spray, like the water spray even, which can come actually on my windscreen and could impair my visibility. That's why the contact between the tires and the roadway deteriorates. This answer is also correct because whenever there is a like there is a wet roadway, maybe because of rain, because of snow, then the grip of your tire on the roadway deteriorate for sure. Braking distances are greater. This is also a correct option because normally when there is a wet roadway, then you braking distances are always greater. When you brake in normal dry condition, maybe the car is stopped, but when the roadway is wet, it will take some time or maybe more distance to brake. So all of three options are correct. So let's move to the next question. Our next question is, where must you specially reckon with ice on the roadway? Like where you can think that there definitely will be some ice on the roadway. So on stretches of the road running through a forest, answer is clear. When some roads are going through the forest, definitely there will be some snow because maybe this side is not like cleared regularly and the forest is there, so the chances of the ice on the roadway are more. Similarly on the bridges, like bridges or the stretches going through a forest, they are not being used that much, or you can say there is no that much flow of traffic that we normally expect on the frequent being used roads like intercity roads or motorways. So on bridges even you can expect more ice way, but on frequently used stretches of the road, as a lot of vehicles are there, maybe the ice is already away, or like there are very less chances that on frequently used stretches of the road you can find a lot of ice. But the roadways where like, or the areas which are not being used that much, like bridges or roads through forest, there you can expect to be more ice. Let's go to the next question. What are special conditions when driving along tree-lined avenues in the cold season? Like whenever you are driving through tree-lined avenues, for example, like let's say I can give you an example. Like here you are traveling on the roadway and there are trees around you, so you need to be very careful about which things. Wet leaves as well as white floors, black ice and snowy surfaces are particularly dangerous above all on cambered roadways, like the roadways which have some patches like incline, then they are going up like cambered roadways. There you can expect very much of black ice, white frost and snowy surfaces. Similarly, the tree-lined avenues are particularly safe in winter because the tree tops protect the road from snow. This answer is not correct. As you know, in winter even like these leaves are away from the trees, and even the tree cannot protect you from the snow. From the tree, even sometimes snow fall with a lot of speed on your windscreen. So trees can never protect you from the snow. White frost and black ice occur more frequently and more unexpectedly on cobbled roadways than on the other roadways. I will try to show you what does it mean by cobbled roadways. Like some roadways with, you can say, blocks like this, cobbled roadways. So here in the patches in where there are some spaces, the ice will be there. So on cobbled roadways you can expect very much ice. So these two options are correct, but the answer that tree can protect you from the snow, this answer was not correct. So only two options are correct. Let's go to the next question. What must you be prepared for here? So here you are, no traffic sign at all, so the rule right before left will apply here. Simple. The 1 point, the 2 point, the traffic sign is showing. If you have already seen our previous videos, the road is going to be narrow at your side, so the oncoming traffic has priority. We have clarified this traffic sign already in our previous videos. So this is the thing. The rain is there, it is raining highly, it is raining heavily. That means that your car could skid. Even many things to consider. So a narrow carriageway, it is clear from this traffic sign. Then an extended braking distance. Yeah, if you brake here, maybe due to rain and these wet leaves on the road, traffic, your braking distance is anyhow greater in wet conditions. A vehicle coming from right, which has priority as per route right before left, could also emerge from the right hand side. All three answers are correct in this situation. Let's move to the next question. Why does driving on this stretch road require great alertness on the part of motorists? So if you see these stretch roads where tram line is also going parallel to you, there are many things to consider. Either tram can come from any direction, then the road has uneven patches, really difficult to control, car could skid, many posts. Driving on the tracks is dangerous, correct? The road surface is uneven and road grip varies. So everywhere the road grip could vary. That's why you need to be very careful about your speed on this particular patches. A tram might come from opposite direction. It's quite evident that a tram can come from any direction. So all three things you have to consider while driving on this particular patches. The road is icy for a short distance. What you should do, avoid here. When the road is icy, try avoid everything. Steering wheel movements unnecessarily, don't move the steering wheel, don't brake unnecessarily, don't accelerate. So all three things you should avoid when there is icy for a short distance. So all three options are very clear and correct. While driving, how can you safely check whether the road is icy? If you are not sure the road is icy, my grip is good or not, so by carefully applying the brakes at very low speed. Just check if the car is skidding, then you can be very sure that the road is icy. So in this condition, you can simply check the road if it is icy or not by simply applying the brake. By rapid acceleration, never. By jerking the steering wheel to left and right, in both cases your car can skid, can go out of your control. So by carefully applying the brakes, you can be sure that either road is icy or not. What must you drive with particular caution here? Why? Because you see, there is already a very sharp turn, so the road is already very tricky and a car is parked here as well, so you cannot see what is coming from there. Oncoming traffic you cannot see. Even you have to be very careful while taking your maneuver because the car is parked, wrongly parked unfortunately. You have very less space to go, and then because of snow your car can skid. So because the roadway is slippery, that's why you need to drive with particular caution here, because the roadway is made narrowed by wrongly parked car. For sure, the road was already narrow and the wrongly parked car has made it even very narrow, because the view is obscured by the bend. If you see, you cannot see what is coming from the opposite direction. So that's why the view is already obscured by the bend. So all three options are correct. let's move to the next question. Where must you be prepared to encounter sudden fog? Where you can? In marshy areas for sure. Near lakes, near rivers. You can, like, it's common sense. Wherever you have the lakes, wherever you have river, marshy areas, there you can expect a sudden fog. Like, you are traveling on the road and you expect a sudden fog whenever these three things or even some more factors are there. Next question is, what do you do if visibility is drastically reduced by the fog? So visibility is reduced. The common thing, you should maintain the safer distance from the vehicle ahead, number one. Number two, and there could be very many options, let's go through it together. Drive up close to the vehicle in front so you can use its rear lights as an orientation point. No, like, there is already fog, you cannot see in front of you. You should be very careful while driving. You should increase the safer distance. Neither you should close the distance, no. Adopt your speed in time to visibility condition. Like, adopt your speed. For example, visibility is low, just reduce your speed to be on the safe side. Increase the distance from the vehicle in front. Another correct option. Not to decrease or drive up close to the vehicle in front. Other than that, you should increase the distance from the vehicle in front of you actually. So, next question, last question for this video. In the next video, we will come with the 32 more questions, but last question for this video. Why do you have to pay particular attention here? You see, the road is taking bend, you do not know where the road will go. So maybe the oncoming traffic can cut your corner, many possibilities. So why do you have to pay particular attention here? Because oncoming traffic could cut the corner, right? Oncoming traffic could cut the corner and could come into your lane. Because it is not clear which direction the road will take. Like, you cannot be sure either it is taking the turn and going left or going right. Could be tricky here. You cannot be very sure because the road surface is uneven. For sure, the road surface is uneven, so you need to be very careful while driving here. So what this option is also correct. So friend, this was everything from this video for topic number 8. That was video number 3 actually for topic number 8. Now in next video, we will complete this topic. Remaining 32 questions will be covered. If you have any question, any query, any doubt, just don't forget to tell us. You can put it in the comment section. You can write us an email. We will put it in the description. If you want to support us on Patreon, you can support us with as low as $1 as well. And we will be waiting for your feedback about it, like how our video series is going on, what betterment we can bring into it. So friends, and to the next video, happy landing. We wish you a very nice day. So take care and bye.